Hey everyone, Charlie here. Good morning. Welcome to the second rambly episode of One Cup of Japan. I am here in Sabae as always. Just come from McDonald's, where it walked like 2 miles just so I could have breakfast at a McDonald's, which is kind of sad, but I'm hoping the fact that I have to walk like 4 miles total will sort of make up for it. But you can see behind me here, getting ready for a festival here at this local shrine. Pretty much all of the shrines around here have already had their summer and now actually their fall festivals. A lot of these, it's not technically fall yet of course, but now that summer is, the really really hot parts of summer are over, the festivals that are going on are just being called fall festivals, which is fair enough. So anyway, if you guys are new to One Cuppa, which I guess everybody really is because, again, second episode. Basically, the way the show works is I have a cup of something on a morning such as this, walk around, talk about what's on my mind, and while doing so, show you some of my tiny chunk of Japan. This morning, I'm walking around like probably one of my favorite areas in the city to run through. And by extension, actually, to walk through, just because can't really tell yet in this little subsection of it, but there are a lot of really cool old houses here. A lot of which look like they're still parts of old like family samurai compounds, right? And also, there's a bunch of shrines. And as any Japanese person will tell you, foreigners have too much an obsession with shrines. Like, can you imagine if, like, there were Japanese people who came to the States, and every time you were with them and you saw a shrine, or not a shrine, a church, or a mosque, or a temple or something, they're just like, oh my god, it's a place of worship, right? And it's equally ridiculous, but whatever, it is what it is. So this week was mired in controversy. A couple months ago now, Jake Naughton, the handsomest of all the pink vest wearing J-vloggers, gave me this idea for a game with my kids, which is basically the kids choose a character from cards that you've made, right? And then they all work together to fight a boss using English language, like Final Fantasy boss fight style. And so it's actually turned into a really successful game. The kids really, really like it. We don't play it all that much just because it's kind of a time suck. But yeah, it's always gone off really, really well. Ooh, people getting ready for a thing that I can't remember the name of here. Let's be respectful and quiet as we pass through. Ooh. Okay. Sorry about that. Ohayou gozaimasu.
YouTube ビデオを作っています。
はい。おはようございます。Japanese lesson. I just used the wrong verb there to make. I didn't even use the verb to record. Just said I'm using. No, never mind. I lied. I used the right verb. Anyway. おはようございます。Okay. Now that we're. Ooh, すげえ。 a bunch of obachans in the kitchen. I've got this little school attached to the... Sorry if you couldn't hear me there, but there's a bunch of obachans in like a little kitchen there attached to that school, cooking all of the festival's meals for this festival. I'm probably not going to go to this one today, because it's far from my house, and it's my day off from running, and I'm injured and other whiny things. But right, so controversy. The characters, right? There are 35 characters in this game. And recently I made an Asuna card from Sword Art Online. Which, whatever, you know, it's fine. She's just another character in the game. But the thing is that she is the second most powerful character in the game. She's stronger than Super Saiyan Goku. Hi, ohayou gozaimasu. Yeah, she's stronger than Super Saiyan Goku. She's stronger than, like, I don't know, Spider-Man, a bunch of other characters. It's irrelevant. But the thing is, I didn't think this would be a big deal because Asuna is an awesome character. She's strong. They totally ruined her. See, this is what I'm talking about with these houses. These old sort of houses that look like they belong in like an old samurai movie, right? These old stone walls, these old sort of walls that look like they're meant to keep people with swords up. But, yeah, so Asuna, she's a great character. She's a strong character. So, of course, I put her in the game. To be honest, mostly because when we play, I want to play as her. I also put in Kirito for what it's worth. He's also a strong character. He's just not as strong as Asuna. Which, think what you will about that. So, anyway, I didn't think this would be such a controversial decision, but sure enough, multiple kids in multiple classes threw like a little piss fit because Asuna, a girl, is stronger than Goku, right? Stronger than base form Vegeta, which, whatever, man. Before we continue this story, so click here. Here's another reason why I really love this part of town. There's tons of these little independent shops, right? What's cool is even when they close for the night, as you can see, there's... I'll show you a close-up here, I guess. There's the vending machines. Bring typical fare, coffee, water, juice. Then, of course, here is your... here's your cigarette machine. And other vending machines. So, but these are cool. I mean, of course, they tend not to have the selection. What's down this way? Let's find out, shall we? They tend not to have the selection of like of normal convenience stores, but the people there are friendlier, appreciate your service, seem to a lot more than convenience stores. Not that convenience stores are unfriendly, but anyway, I digress. Back to the RPG controversy, right? Yeah, so basically, Asuna, very strong character, stronger than all these other male characters. And I guess I could have expected like one or two, like, oh, she's a girl, like, you know, typical ingrained mentality. But the amount of just like, yeah, the response just was ridiculous and saddening. Saddening? Saddening. But the thing is, too, that on the flip side of that, one of my female students... Oh, right, there's a school down this way, and I do not want to film a school. Bad news. But one of my female students was so happy, and not because... There are other female characters in the game. There's like, there's Elsa, there's Anna, there's like a couple of the girls from what is that show that Man in Japan is awkwardly fascinated with? Precure, I think. So like Flora and one of the other ones, Perfume, maybe her name is in it. Anyway, there's other characters in it. But she was so happy that there was a character that was not only like, that not only the boy players would potentially want to be because she's strong, but also that there was a character that she could be, right? And be a girl, right? Which, you know, this boils down to like gender politics and a lot of stuff that's been going on in video games and everything else like that. But related to this, I mean, the controversy is not going to get me fired. The kids aren't going to hate me. So it's not that big of a deal, of course. But I went back and looked at the character roster, right? And found myself a little bit ashamed. Because while I didn't expect that the boys would have a negative reaction to Asuna, I didn't expect the girls to have such an overwhelmingly positive reaction to her. And one of the reasons why may be the fact that in a game now where I have 35 different characters from different games, TV shows, and whatever, there are 12 female characters. Right? And most of them, as far as like their abilities and their strength go, are middling at best, right? They're sort of like middle of the pack. So, in other words, I've been sort of like an unconscious sexist to my classes, my students, and that's not cool, man. You can't do that. So I guess that's the end of that story, but the point is, for all you would-be teachers out there, or current teachers, make sure, representation, man. Like, even if you think about it when you're out in the real world, so to speak, and you make conscious decisions not to support things and, you know, get involved in causes and stuff like that, you're not immune to... There's an old woman that is mad dogging me right now. just think about how games might be making your students feel, I guess, which is kind of a no-brainer, right? But alas, I am myself a no-brainer. So here we are now. This is actually my most favorite stretch. Look at this here. This is just beautiful. Right? These old fences. I don't know that there are any along this route, but there are actually a lot of pomegranate trees, which blew my mind the other day when I was running to come across pomegranates growing wildly. I don't know. I don't know what I was saying, I guess, to be honest. Lost my train of thought. But yeah. So that was the big thing this week, but also, I don't know why I'm saying also. I'm getting crazy with my words. But ooh, temple. Shime-san, yon-shome, okay. Now we're getting close to my subsection here. Let's take a look here at what we're walking towards. Sorry about the shoddy Cameron-ship? Camera work this morning. I don't know that I want to go in here with a camera. But anyway, this does make me think. Starting tomorrow, this is pretty cool, right? It's beautiful here. What's really interesting too, as you'll see, is that connected to a lot of these temples, there are playgrounds. You can see one right over here. This over by the road where you come in, which, I don't know, is that unusual? Do we have playgrounds near churches and stuff back home? I don't know. But related to all this exploration, there has been a charge leveled against me that... Okay, how are we doing? We're about halfway there. Okay. That my claims that Fukui is a boring bastion of geriatrics is a vicious and inaccurate claim. And so I've been wondering about this, of course, as I do tend to overthink things. Look at this house. This is amazing. Well, there's people in there. But yeah, if you can see behind me real quick. Gorgeous, right? Want. But yeah, so this claim that I've not been fair to my adoptive home. And so I've been thinking that maybe that's true. So starting tomorrow, I'm going to be starting a new series. I don't know why I'm on like a series kick recently, but probably because they're easy, right? Series are always easy to shoot because you know exactly what you have to do. Anyway, but the series, what the Fukui can you do with 2,000 yen? So, I don't know if the name gets this across or not, but just in case you're as dense as I am, basically, I'm going to be taking you guys around, initially just in Fukui City, to show you what kind of, look at this house, amazing, beautiful, right? To show you exactly what you can do, just for 2,000 yen, right? The food you can get, the places you can go, the nerdy items you can buy. And not only will this show you guys like a part of Japan that I don't know that I've ever seen a video on besides on this channel, but also maybe it will prove me wrong and maybe I'll stop poo-pooing Fukui all the time. Not that I do it all the time, I think. I like things here, like Akiyoshi and Yakitori shop. I like ramen shops. You know, I like stuff. But anyway, point is that starting tomorrow, I'm gonna start filming this series. But what I would like you guys to do is get at me with some ideas for themes. One second here, let's be as respectful as we can be with a camera in our hand. Okay. Get at me with some themes. Like, do you want to see episodes that are like focused on like historical attractions? Should I be seeking out like bastions of capitalism? It's like I'm gonna use bastions in this video, by the gods. Should I be looking for things centered around otaku culture, food, whatever the case may be? Let me know what you guys want to see, because that helps me, that'll help keep me from being like, well, here's a cheap food place, and here's a free temple, and whatever, right? So help me make more interesting episodes, but... So leave that stuff in the comments below. So this, some of you may recognize, this is Kabutoyama. Back when I was doing the travelogue videos, this is one of like the couple places I did. Maybe this is the first place I did, I don't remember, but... Kabutoyama, I think, and I'm just struggling to remember here, I think it is from something like ridiculously old time. I could read a sign. I'll read a sign, okay? Jeez. Get out of my face. it's real old. It's real, real old. I said like 400. See, the problem of reading these signs is that they list the Japanese year, right? The like reign of the emperor year, and then the number of that year. So with the exception of Showa and Heiwa years, which I think, anyway, I can't read those. But anyway, point is, this temple, which in fact is actually a huge burial mound that is shaped like a samurai's helmet, hence the name Kabutoyama, Kabuto Mountain. It's been here since like 500 or something like that, which is just freaking incredible, right? I mean, just as an American, where American history in the broader sense, not United States history, American history has sort of been paved over destroyed, burned. You know, American history is not exactly friendly to those sort of things. Oh, I'm getting the shakes. Switch hands here. It's incredible to me when things that are that old still remain unscathed, right? And people still come here to appreciate them. Looks like there's going to be another festival here later. Maybe I'll come to this one a little bit closer to home. But again, kind of feeling lazy today. Sometimes I almost step in bees' nests that are built into the ground, which would be a very terrible time. I feel pretty comfortable in saying. So one thing I want to talk about. No, this is an apology. Nah, I don't want to dive into personal stuff here on the vlog. That is that would violate my code of Charlie knows that Seikatsu staying drama free, of course. But here's something I would like to know. What is the thing that annoys people most about channels? And I ask this in a really bad way, obviously, but I mean, what is it that turns you off the most? Like, do you hate when people can't, like, nail down what their channel is, whether it's like whether it's an informational channel, a vlog, a music channel, whatever, or can you get away with, ooh, excuse me, that's disgusting, sorry, or can, like, well, you let people get away with anything so long as you like the personality. And I've been thinking about this a lot recently, just because, I don't know if any of you guys watch this really small, oh, hello, kitty. If any of you guys watch this really small indie YouTuber by the name of PewDiePie. I hope I'm saying that right. But he's recently started doing like a lot of like daily vlogging, right? And it's really, really, I think it's been like really, really successful for that channel. Obviously comparing this channel to that is folly. Ridiculous, whole bunch of other negative, presumptuous adjectives. But, I don't know, it always surprises me when people can get, like, away with that. And I guess when you have that big of a subscriber base, people just be like, whatever, bro. But, I don't know. Sorry, that's a rambly thought. But that does bring us quite successfully to the local cento. We're getting pretty close to my apartment, huh? And this is the public bathhouse, which you cannot see through the thicket of wheat, so I'll show you here in a second. But I've never been to the cento. Just because cento basically is, like I said, it's a public bathhouse, but a lot of them are made up to look like onsens, like hot springs, right? So they'll have artificial rock features, or they'll have they'll plant bamboo and make walls out of bamboo or stone or whatever, so that they look like any other, like a naturally occurring hot spring. But the thing is, and this is why I never found the point of them and why I never go, is because they don't, like, there's no real health benefit, right? When you go to an onsen, you're like enjoying like a natural wonder, right? A natural wonder of the natural world. It's good for your skin, blah blah blah, super relaxing, which maybe these are relaxing too, but I just don't see, like, unless you live in a closet, like even the shittiest mansions, like I'm talking one or two steps below my mansion, which is pretty well up there on the shittiness scale, will have, you know, they have a shower or something. So I just never understood why go to a public bath. if it's not an, also an actual onsen. But anyway, yeah, we've been walking up past it here. And you'll see it's kind of an unremarkable building. And attached to it, there's a gym. There's like a, not an event center, like a performance center, because they teach dance classes here. Which I've often thought that I might get involved in a dance class. I like Jake Knowlton, but I'm not nearly as cool. So yeah, here it is. You can see it's not really anything special. Just a place where people go to get naked and rub the dirt off their Weibos. Hi, gozaimasu. Dead air live streaming, doodly-doo. This isn't live streaming, what am I talking about? So, let's finish this up by talking about something that I can't really talk about in too much detail just yet. Although I could, I guess, but I choose not to. Within the next couple of weeks, in fact, within the next 2 weeks, I will be, not just me, along with someone else that you all should know and love, will be launching a new YouTube channel. And I'm really, really, really excited about that. So, but on that note, I think probably what happened, is there another matsuri happening here? I feel like I'm missing like a town-wide or a nationwide cultural event. It's the beginning of Silver Week here, which is just like a mini golden week, a half a golden week for me. I have like 4 days off. But anyway, taking a little bit of attention away from this channel to go and talk about stuff. Yeah, so I hope you guys will check that out. I'm really, really excited for it to launch. It's going to be very, very different from this channel, at least as far as its content goes. I'm still me, I'm still an idiot, so I'm sure the style is going to be very much the same. But won't be Japan related at all. But I'm really excited to be able to announce that. I've been working on like some video ideas with my partner. So that's exciting. Oh, it smells so good here. It smells like pine. Really wish somebody was here, because this is my shrine now. This is where I would go for like New Year's, or like this is where I went a couple months ago for the summer festival. So I really wish somebody was here so I could ask them what time this starts, because this is like a 5-minute walk from my house, you know. And what's great about these is that you can come here, spend no money if you'd prefer not to, and watch a taiko performance, meet some really cool people. Chances are people are gonna try and buy you drinks if you're a foreigner, because they're like, oh hey, check out this guy, let's welcome him type of thing, you know? And it's just a really, really cool cultural experience. But on that note, before I gotta follow the rules, right? Gotta be at the end of the cuppa. Does it count as a cuppa? I don't know, it's a cup, so. But yeah, anyway guys, let's wind this down now with this beautiful backdrop of the path away from the shrine behind me here in Shinmei Shrine. Thanks always for watching, guys. Please let me know down in the comments if you enjoyed this installment of Cuppa. Like I said, get at me about things you want to see for the What the Fukui show, and anything else at all. If you want to tell me how ugly my face is, that's okay. You won't be telling me anything I don't know. So on that note, guys, thanks always for watching. Thanks for taking the time to watch, for commenting, for liking, whatever, for hating, whatever the case may be. Always appreciate it, and I will see you very soon indeed. Cheers.